viewers drop 20K. All right, so Tweak is coming up. He is our Glitch 6 singles champion. Going to get a quick interview with the king right here. And don't worry, I'll own up to my mistakes. I always do. Please take a seat, my friend. The king himself, the winner of Glitch 6 singles here at Xanadu Games at Laurel Park. We got Tweak. He's got earbuds in. Can he hear me?
It's attached to my body.
I was going to say, can you hear me in those? All right, I got to be honest with you. When Nairo came up after that last set, he beat Leo, he beat Light. And I was like, Nairo with the momentum is unstoppable. Mm-hmm. I think a reset is, like, certain. Mm-hmm. I was very wrong. Like, I want to know, as sitting in winner's bracket, when you're in winner's finals and then you win and you go to grand finals and you don't get to play for a little bit, how do you keep your momentum up? How do you keep your, like, yourself warm?
I don't know. Honestly, like, there's not as much of a break compared to waiting for that than, like, any other set, really.
Okay.
When you're in, like, winner's top 16, like, every set kind of starts to take
That's
a
true.
While.
That's true.
So, like, I don't really play or anything, but I'm always trying to stay, like, you know, like, mentally focused. My main goal all the time is to try to, like, consciously tell myself to be confident in my options since the game is so new. Like, go for that thing that you're unsure will work.
Sure.
And it also, you know, make the other player hesitate and get scared of you, I guess.
Yeah.
That's just my main mindset, like, mentally when I play.
In
this game specifically.
One thing that I noticed is I saw you get caught under the stage against Nairo with that Wario up B using the bike.
But the camera...
The camera does that. It does it a lot, yeah.
I thought I was closer to the edge.
But one of the really cool things I saw was that you kind of laughed it off, and that's not something that we've seen from you, like, way back, and it really seems like you've kind of worked on your mental and known, I can win this no matter what. And do you think that comes as a result of, I mean, you've just been dominant in this game. You won Let's Make Moves. Are you more? Do you feel more confident in your abilities, or is it just like...
I think it's a mix of, like, I think I've improved mentally, but I still have hiccups.
Sure.
But I think it's a mix of, you know, I'm comfortable, like, two sets of grand finals, playing Wario, you know, I can always win because of my win condition with Waft. You know, I'm also playing Nairo, someone who I've played against for years, like, he's my friend, like, and I guess it's just a mix of all that plus just enjoying the game.
Yeah. I mean, watching you play is just something on another level. We
were
talking about it, and, like, Let's Make Moves, it was very clear that, like, this guy is the best player in the room. And this time it was a little bit closer, obviously, because Nairo just...
Lots of close calls.
He turns up, and it feels like...
He scares you into doing something that you wouldn't do normally.
Silly stuff, right?
And then you get... You just die.
The level of pressure is insane. And I feel like... Did you feel like he was playing more the matchup as it went on? Because it feels like early on, he's playing the player, and then he's like,
He started to get leads and wall me out a little bit
more. Yeah, I have a sword, and I'm against Wario.
Yeah. That matchup definitely is still really rough.
Yes.
But, Wario just being better in general, and I think the game is more fitting for him, just how the mechanics are.
Yeah.
It's winnable, but still very bad for Wario.
So, I saw you play Wario, obviously pulled Young Link out a couple times against Wadi. So, I want to talk about the Young Link, because I'm kind of fan-geeking out about this.
Yeah, I do need to talk about the Young Link, because he's very new.
Well, it's very new, but what kept happening is, I think this happened against... against Wadi, and then it happened against Nairo or somebody.
Jackal,
I can't remember.
In top 16.
Well, it happened against Jackal, but during top 8, you were down like 3-1, and you won with that character. How are you like...
That was against Nairo, yeah.
Yeah, how are you... So with Wario, you know your win condition. It's like, okay, up tilt fart, late up air, something like that. But with Young Link, how are you... A character that has trouble killing a lot of the time, how are you staying that sort of sturdy?
My Young Link is new to tournaments, along with being new in general. I've been playing him for a few days. So I think I just naturally played better as time went on, and I got more used to the tournament setting with Young Link because I practice him with Cosmos and a couple other people this weekend. I kind of toned down the flashy stuff from friendlies and like try to like actually play.
Arrow, up B.
Yeah,
I saw you go for that. It's like, eh.
Yeah, it's good. I'm still figuring out knowing like this will it'll work now. Like, because it's quite the commitment if it doesn't work. Majora's Mask is my favorite game ever, so Young Link was a character I was going to try. And after trying, I'm like, okay, this character's kind of good.
He's very good.
He's very good.
I know you really wanted Skull Kid.
Yeah.
I know.
That's like the closest thing I got.
I know. Well, I'm sad that you're not going to get your character, and I am because Banjo's coming, but, you know, that's just me.
I think it's possible. Very likely.
I think it's a certainty. 100% for sure. So my last question, of course, This was a huge win for you. Yeah. 550 entrants and proving that you can do it even with the best of the best here.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think this means for you personally leading into Genesis, one of the biggest events of the year in 2 weeks, 2,000 entrants? I mean, this has got to be a huge boon for your confidence.
Yeah, so for like factual stuff, this win means a lot for like seeding at Genesis, I guess.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
I mean, unless the seeding is bad or something, but. I don't know, it was a nice confidence boost to be able to like win with my new character, you know, make a bunch of comebacks and, you know.
Oh.
Thank you.
Oh, DJ Nintendo in the
and, I also beat Light, who I lost to before, so
yep.
that was nice. Because he's basically the only person at this event that I really wanted to play. Leo would be nice too, but Light was the only one that I would pick out of everyone.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm really happy I could win, just like any other tournament. Just going to continue trying to do my thing at Genesis, I guess.
Of course. Have you
a lot
you
more nerves at that tournament. Oh, my God.
Oh, God, yeah. I can imagine. Have you played Leo at all? Did you play him in Winter? Sorry,
nope.
Can't remember. Okay. Now, how do you think you would fare against the Ike?
Because
it's Wario.
My biggest problem with all these top players is... Well, one, I play so many characters that it gets rough. And
yep.
Two, I don't want to put myself in a bad position because I definitely have a good option all the time with all the characters I play. So I'm just going to try to look at the character, maybe play the character myself and see what is my best pick against Leo.
Of course.
And, you know, Leo doesn't just play Ike, so we'll see what happens.
That's true. Apparently it's like his sixth best character.
Yeah.
So he's got the cloud also. Just parry the
air. A
lot
of people have been saying that type of stuff.
Him and Salem, I'm like, okay, well, you're down 0-2, so
That's
pick your best character.
Saying.
We were saying the same thing. We were like, okay, yeah, you're really good. Like, pick your best character.
Yeah.
Get the hell out of here.
Down 0-2 and, like, you all right. You
stick
got
with
it.
Yeah, Malink. Yeah, bro. Okay. I'm not Target Chance. Anyway. Just parry the air. You'll be fine. Just parry the air. All right. Well, I don't want to keep you any longer. Dude, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Getting a little misty-eyed and personal here. This guy is, like, one of my favorite players.
Thank
and,
you.
Like, way early on when he was still playing Bowser Jr.,
yeah.
He showed up to his Xanadu. I was like, he was playing Bowser Jr., shows up to his Xanadu. We start playing. I was like, this dude's Jr. is nice. This dude's Wario is nice. This kid is nice. Why is he playing this character? And he was
no
funny
one remembers
as hell.
The Wario. Well, some people might.
I asked you. Yeah. Do you remember that on Twitter? I was like, where's the Wario? You're like, give me back my tires. And I was like.
I actually just realized that as you started to say that sentence. Yeah. Dude, he was the last character I expected to be like, I'm going to use him in tournament, but like jump squat stuff makes up air walk
yes.
work for so long.
And just the
three stocks is a great environment for like Wario.
Because you
like,
get first and last
walk.
Yeah, and getting like clap, wait for air dodge, clap again. Like you can mix up people so hard.
Yeah.
Anyway, I don't want to take up too much time.
He messes with you when you're shielding.
Yes.
It's not like Peach level stuff, but because a lot of it's like easy to parry, but like he can mix you up.
Dude, I saw you continually.
And he has a command grab.
You kept landing into people with up airs, and they were scared to do anything.
Yeah.
Like, all right, we're going to geek out on stream. I love this guy. I love Wario. Like, I'm a Wario
too,
secondary, so this is super cool. Dude, again, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I'm going to see you at Genesis. We're going to let, I think EE's going to interview Nairo coming up very shortly. Guys, thank you guys for tuning in to Glitch 6. Stay tuned.